Tesla Gigapress maker IDRA has released a new photo which you're seeing on your screen and says the future of die casting is not only Gigapress but some more. They say this machine below will produce electric motor rotors. What it means? Welcome back again. This is Armin Haray and friends from torquenews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to this channel for daily Tesla breaking news. So Tesla Gigapress supplier IDRA appears to have another disruptive machine in the works, and it might end up being used by key clients like the US-based electric vehicle maker Tesla. This was hinted at in a rather interesting image that was uploaded to social media on their LinkedIn account, which you're seeing on your screen. The company noted that the future of die casting is not only the Gigapress. There is still quite a bit of innovation left in smaller segments, much smaller segments. The company posted a photo of component of one such machine on its official LinkedIn account. IDRA's new machine, as noted by the Gigapress supplier, would be producing electric motor rotors. But while the company machine is interesting enough, EV advocates have observed that the component was painted in colors that look quite similar to those that have been delivered to Tesla. This is why I said this is very likely that Tesla will use this. While it is yet to be seen if Tesla will acquire such a machine from IDRA, the electric vehicle maker would probably need such a contraption when it starts the production of its compact electric car, which will be produced in Gigafactory Mexico. The vehicle, which is expected to be priced at around $25,000 range, is expected to see more production than the Model Y and Model 3 combined. Tesla's compact car will be produced on the company's next generation platform, which is designed to be significantly more efficient to produce than the Model 3 and Model Y, as noted by Tesla CFO Zachary Kirkhorn during the 2023 Investor Day event. The next generation platform will enable a 50% reduction in costs. This means that the total cost of ownership of Tesla's next generation car will also be lower than the company's vehicles today. Such an estimate is quite impressive, friends, especially considering that the Model 3 is already cheaper to own than the Toyota Corolla today, as per the company during its 2023 Investor Day event. So Tesla is very likely to acquire this Gigapress. Why? Because if this is going to produce electric motor rotors, Tesla will need to do everything it can to lower the cost of its $25,000 car. And if Tesla acquires this type of machine, they can die-cast them, make it cheaper to produce, and thus lower the cost of their $25,000 compact vehicle, making it more affordable and being able to sell them to more people at lower prices. So what do you think? Do you like this, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Truckers have started to review Pepsi Tesla Semi, and they find some very interesting things, especially a main issue with the center seats. There is an interesting discussion on Reddit about the Pepsi Tesla Semi truck, which hit the road a few weeks ago. Pepsi received them back in February or March, I think. They are like $250,000 a piece. Based on what modern ICE semis and passengers electric vehicle cost, this seems super reasonable to me, don't you think? But truckers who reviewed them are concerned about one particular issue, and actually more than one, and that has to do with Tesla Semi's center seat. Let's see what it is. The driver of the Tesla Semi is centered in the cabin. That's got to be strange for the driver, commented one trucker. Here's what the issue is. A user named PuddleSRS says he remembers hearing a trucker reviewing the center seat specifically. He says, this can become an issue if Tesla plans for a major rollout. I don't remember everything that the trucker said, he says, about the truck, but I do remember the seat. The main issue is arriving at gatehouses for deliveries at warehouses or factories or other such things. These gatehouses are set up so that a driver can hand over their paperwork to the guard without leaving their truck or out the driver's side window. If you put the driver in the middle, the driver has to leave their seat to hand over paperwork. This is suboptimal at best, they say, especially when you may have a line of trucks impatiently waiting behind you. Of course, if there is a regional distribution fleet, then the problem all but disappears. They check in at the home gatehouse, where paperwork may not be required or they need to physically go into the office to check in. This would also likely be no gate at the delivery site, and they would need to leave their truck anyway to make the delivery, he says. Now, you see, in order to design a semi-truck's cabin, you have to consult with truckers. Another huge issue is the entry to the Tesla semi. One other user says, you have to enter from a back door and walk through the cabin to get to the driver's seat, instead of a normal truck entering from right next to the driver's seat. What this means is, in wet, mud, snow, etc., you have to walk with your filthy shoes through the entirety of your cab to get to the driver's seat, versus what most drivers do of getting in just the driver's seat and slipping your shoes off when you go back into the rest of your cab living space when not driving, to keep the rest of your cabin clean. Now, generally, truckers in this discussion, friends, think that Tesla Semi's designers should have more closely consulted with actual truckers so they know what their habits are and how they do their work. I'm sure Tesla has done it. I can't imagine Tesla hasn't done this, but at least this is what truckers say. Now, in my previous reports, I've spoken very favorably about the Tesla Semi. And in my opinion, from a logistical point of view, getting out of your seat would barely add any time to what truckers already have to go through. The time at the gate isn't the issue. The time at the dock is. That's what some truckers say. Now, waiting an hour plus for workers to show to unload is a bigger issue. Also, you know, truckers spend a lot of times, endless hours, by sitting in their trucks while driving. Maybe it's a little exercise, a little extra exercise and a little extra movement to get out of your seat, hand over your paperwork, and then move back to your seat and continue driving. So what do you think about this? Apparently there are other issues, and if hopefully someone from Tesla listens to these things, they can pass it to the Tesla designing team and they can come up with some improvements in the second edition of Tesla Semi, or when they roll out the entire Semi truck in big quantities mass production. New images of Giga Berlin show Tesla focusing on what matters, friends. There is a recent tweet from Twitter user GF4Tesla, which showcases a series of new images of Tesla Giga Berlin factory. The images depict the logistics area of Giga Berlin is well filled, and the delivery of the Model Y is running at full speed. You are seeing those images on your screen. And Jürgen, who tweets at GF4Tesla, has been chronicling Tesla Giga Berlin from day one. Now, looking at the comments under the tweet, it is clear that people are excited about the progress of the factory and the potential impact it will have on the automotive industry. Many commenters are also impressed with the speed at which the factory has been constructed and now ramping the production and delivery of the Model Y, not only in Germany, but throughout Europe. One commenter notes that Tesla has chosen a strategic location of the Gigafactory Berlin, as it is close to a major port, uses rails, which will make it easier to export vehicles to other countries in Europe. Other commenters highlight the environmental benefits of electric cars and praises Tesla's commitment to sustainable manufacturing. Friends, overall, as you can see from these images, the factory is making great progress at Giga Berlin. What makes the factory so special? Well, the Tesla Giga Berlin factory represents the future of manufacturing, and not only for Tesla. It's also great to see the progress Tesla is making on the assembly lines of Giga Berlin. This electric vehicle manufacturing factory, a state-of-the-art factory that will produce some of the best electric cars in the world. I mentioned that Giga Berlin's location is strategic. This is important because Tesla wants to make electric cars accessible to everyone, not just people in the local area. The factory's location will make it easier to transport cars to other parts of Europe and beyond. Looking at these images, it is clear, in my opinion, that Tesla Giga Berlin factory is a significant development for the automotive industry, for sustainable manufacturing, and for the local economy of Giga Berlin, about which I've already spoken before. Well, we'll be following the progress closely, and we'll look forward to seeing the impact it has on the world electronic car market.